Honestly, at this point, I feel like if you can see my mustache, you're a little bit too close.
Spiritual ginger.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Bienvenidos nuevamente a mi canal. I hope you guys are doing good. I hope you guys are doing well. And we're back. We are back with another video. This is a full get ready with me kind of sort of situation. Shout out to Bly Hair for sponsoring today's video. We love a good sponsor. Okay, we love a hair sponsor. So I will be installing this unit in the beginning of the video. I'm not really talking or anything like that. I'm just gonna have you guys watch, and I will have all the specs of this hair listed right next to me, either here or here, whenever I start to install the hair. So if you wanna see how I got this look and how I installed this unit and all that jazz, then keep on watching. But before we get into the video, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And turn on your bell notification so you do get notified every time I post a new video. Let's get into the video.
So you say you wanna get away. We don't need a plane, I could be your escape. Take you to a place where there's no time, no space. I could be your private island on a different planet. Anything could happen. Listen to the waves, let them wash away your pain. Love could be your fantasies.
Okay, so you guys just saw me install this unit, and I'm probably gonna have to straighten it again. I did straighten it though. I don't know if my camera picked that up. I don't know if I did that on camera or off camera. But anyways, I did cut the ends because they were a little bit too thin for my liking. I like my ends to be, you know, thick and luscious. You see, it is a T-part wig, so meaning I can only part it in the middle, and it has like a little bit of space in the front where you could, like, you know, customize it. I personally like to treat these types of wig like a closure wig. The only difference is that you have a little bit more room on the sides to, like, style and customize. But I like to use them very much so glueless or just with hairspray. I'm sorry for the noise. I'm very sorry for the noise. Okay, let's try that again. So that's basically what I did. I just did it like glueless. I put it really tight, like the adjustable straps that come with the wig. I haven't filmed this so long that I don't even know how to do a video no more. But I just used the adjustable straps on the wig and just put it really tight so it's like snug on my head. But I just put it on with some hairspray. You can create some baby hairs if you want to. I personally chose to go without any baby hairs this time. Well, today. So, yeah. Then I cut the ends. It was originally an 18-inch wig. I don't know what it is now. Maybe like 16? 16, 14? I don't really know. I actually wanted it even shorter, but I was on FaceTime with my cousin while I was doing this, and she was like, oh, that length is cute. Leave it like that. So I'm just going to leave it like that. Anyways, we are going to get into my makeup today. I wanted to do like a full get ready with me kind of sort of situation. I don't know. I will be shooting some sponsored content today for the most part. I am going to be doing my makeup with you guys so you guys can see kind of how I do my makeup and stuff. One of the products that I will be shooting a sponsored content for, I will be using in this video. And then I'm also going to be showing you guys what I'm going to wear. I think, I'm not sure, but I'm thinking about it. Why did that door just do that? I don't know where. Whatever. Wow, I look like a child. I look like a kid. I will be touching my hair a lot in this video because I'm just not used to having straight hair. And I need to straighten it again. I see. Whatever. So if you guys see any white flakes on my hair, it's a hairspray. I will be doing my brows first, and I'm just gonna speed up the process, and then I'll be back to like talk to you guys. I don't know what's up with my brows today, but they're not coming out as I would like them to. I feel like they're super thick and they're super duper dark, but I don't know if it's a straight hair or if it's that I'm having a terrible brow day. Might be both, who knows. But I'm having crazy breakouts, so I'm going to be double concealing, because even though it has to be like a skin type of what is it called? It is to showcase like my skin, but honestly, there's certain things about my skin that right now I would not like to showcase. That's just the honest truth. Which this pimple right here, I broke out after my period. It's just a big giant hole right now. And it's so like fresh, so it's like kind of like red, like reddish, I don't really know. So I wouldn't want to showcase that. So I'm going to cover that up with my foundation. I just used the Makeup Revolution foundation stick in F13. I love that. I always use that. But I'm literally just going to do that on like one side. I should probably do it on both just to like balance it out. But if I have any severe like acne scars or active acne, I try to double conceal. So I conceal underneath my foundation and I also conceal after. Well, I don't really conceal after. I just spot conceal before and then I just do my under eyes, whatever. Okay, so I just put some super bright concealer underneath my eyes. What I'm going to do now is that I will be putting this little thing on. I thought they sent me two shades, but then I looked at it and it's the same shade. So this is the number two. This is the deep number two. So, but I'm just gonna blend out my concealer. I'm not letting my concealer sit for absolutely too long just because it is a skin-like look that I'm going for. So I'm not going for a full coverage look. I'm just going for a very much so everyday light to medium coverage. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to do half of my face with a sponge and the other half with a brush, I think. So I'm just gonna shake this. I didn't color match myself. I had to pick this online. Just by looking at it right away, I can tell it's really red, but because it is a tinted moisturizer, it doesn't really have much coverage, meaning when I blend this out, I should be able to blend it in seamlessly with my skin, or so I think. I'm just putting all my hair back, and I'm taking a flat kabuki brush on this side. And this goes our blend in. It smells really, really good. It is very, very red on me. Clearly, I am not the best at color matching one line. What I can tell though is that a little goes a long way. Wait. Aren't you supposed to put tinted moisturizer on with your hands? I'm not sure. Either way, I'm going to... Actually, you know what? I'm going to blend everything out with a brush. It is extremely red. I look like a panda. But guess what? I'm gonna find a way to make this work. So when it's like this, and as I said, a little goes a long way, I think that using a dry beauty blender is the best thing you can do because it's gonna pick up a lot of product from your face, which is what you want in this case, because I just used too much, honestly. Damn, if I would have had a more neutral color. It's red undertone based and I'm golden. I'm golden neutral. So yeah, it was to be expected, but I didn't know it was a red undertone. Like, I don't think the camera is picking it up, but in real life it is really, really, really red compared to like my actual skin. So I'm going to balance that out. I'm going to put some of my concealer. This is a super light concealer. So, and now I'm highlighting again. And the only reason why I'm doing it like this is because it helps me balance out the redness in the foundation. I'm just gonna blend that out with a beauty blender. I'm using the same beauty sponge. The only thing red based that I use on my face on an everyday, like day-to-day basis, is my bronzer. I try to avoid red undertones and stuff like that because it makes me look so freaking orange. I like the coverage that it gives, the little coverage that it gives, the tinted moisturizer, and I also like how it feels on the skin. The only issue that I'm having right now is the color matching. Like, the color don't really match me, but there's literally nothing we can't fix with some highlight and contour. You can already tell it looks way, like, better on my forehead and around this area right here. Oh yes, honey, this looks much, much, much better. And that's on balancing out the colors. Okay. Okay, so I'm going to take my Sasha Buttercup powder to set my under eyes and the highlighted areas of my face. This powder is so messy. Oh, child, I almost spilled my whole shit. So now I'm going to go ahead and bronze up my face. But before I do that, I'm using the Makeup Revolution Glow Bronzer. You guys know this is my favorite go-to bronzer. I love it. But I'm going to create some dimension on my eyelids. So I'm taking a blending brush and I'm just putting this contour bronzing shade on the outer corner. I'm literally just gonna create a shadow. That's it. I'm just creating a shadow. Then I'm going to bronze my face. I don't know what just happened here, but whatever. Wow, I definitely should have removed my fucking mustache. Honestly, at this point, I feel like if you can see my mustache, you're a little bit too close. So I'm gonna do my highlighter, and I'm using the Amreezy highlighter because that gives me like a wet, nice wet little effect, and I like that. I'm still thinking if I want lashes or not. I feel like I do. Okay, so I'm gonna see if I can put these lashes on before my camera dies. It's about to die. Oh yeah, lashes was definitely needed. It just completed the whole look. Even the whole straight hair situation. This look is coming to an end. I'm going to be using Cork lip liner. Can you guys hear the birds? And then I'm just going to take some clear lip gloss. This is from Pop Beauty. This is the Pout Plump Pout. Actually, it's not giving what it's supposed to give. So I'm going to go in with Chestnut on top just to make my lip line a little bit darker. It's still not giving like what I wanted to give, so I'm going to go in with a super super light lip gloss in the center. But I'm literally just putting it in the very center of my lips just to give it some dimension, definition, whatever you want to call it. Honestly, I'm just gonna leave like that because if I keep doing something to it, I'm just gonna mess it up. I already know, been there, done that. Okay, so this is the final look, you guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. My final thoughts about the hair is that I really, really like it. Now that my makeup is done and I'm all dressed and all of that stuff, I really like this length on me. It looks cute, but it's still giving me grown vibes. It's not giving me you're 5 years old anymore as it was in the beginning. But let's just give them a second. Okay, so yeah, it's not giving me oh you're 5 years old anymore. It's kind of giving me a little bit of like, okay, grown vibes, you know, I'm on my grown woman vibe situation or whatever. So I really like it. I really love this. I love this whole look. So this is the final look. I really love how this makeup look turned out. Like, super simple, super, like, I want to say dewy, because I'm not super, super matte, but I'm not super, super dewy. But it's like, I'm not oily, but I'm not matte. It's like a dewy finish. I like it. I like it a lot. And it is super lightweight. The L'Oreal Skin Paradise Tinted Moisturizer. Bomb. The only thing is the color matching. I need to get better at that. But listen, it's online, so what could you really expect? So shout out to Bly Hair for sponsoring to this video. Thank you so much for wanting to partner with me on this video. I love this unit. I really like it. It's like a really go to run errands, put a cap on, don't really have to do too much type of unit. And we love units like that, because even though I love wigs and I love frontals and I love, you know, doing the whole wig situation, sometimes I'm in a rush or sometimes I'm just not in the mood. So it's nice to have a wig I could literally just throw on and go up on my day. I don't know if I mentioned it, but I didn't bleach the knots on this wig. I didn't do anything to this wig. I wanted to see how realistic and good looking I could get it right off the box. For now, I think it's cute, and I already knew I didn't want to do any baby hairs or anything like that. So honestly, to me, this is perfect. I will leave all the specs of this hair in the description box down below. So don't forget to check out Bly Hair, and all the information will be in the description box down below. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching today's video. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial. It wasn't really much of a tutorial. I kind of just did my makeup in front of the camera, and I did my hair and all of that jazz. If you guys like this video, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, share this with friends and family. I see you guys in the next one. Bye.